Tokozani. Hi everyone, please welcome to Gogoma House Spiritual Channel. This is part 3 of Ancestors, Spiritual Guides, and the Universe Message for the people born under the star sign of Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, and the Pisces. Like I've said, I've done my shuffling, I've done my prayers, I've done everything that I'm supposed to do. We are under a very good and positive energy right now. We are so lucky to be here today, guys. I'm going to start with the Sagittarius. These are the people who are ruled by the ninth house of the zodiac sign. They're born between November 22 and December 21. Excuse me. Sagittarius, I have for you the winter. It says, take care of your needs. I also have the worm moon. It says, faith. You know, what I'm getting for you, my beautiful Sagittarius, it says that, I sense someone who have been, you know, through a lot in the past months. You know, you've been working very hard, trying to please other people, putting other people first, and you forgot about yourself. Now, from the 15th of March to 31st of March, all you need to do is to, you know, to take care of your needs. Take care of your needs, you know. You are also important. You need to be strong. Because if you don't take care of your needs, you won't be able to help other people. But then by taking care of your needs, you know, you make sure that you are spiritually okay, you divine properly, and then you'll be able to help other people. This is what your spiritual guides, this is what your angels, your ancestors, and the universe want you to do. And they are saying that, yes, you do have faith, and they really like that about you, because with your faith, everything is manifesting the way it is supposed to. Everything is going right, and at the end of the day, you're going to, you know, to produce good results, good products from what you're working on. And what you will be producing, you'll be sharing it with other people, because you have a good heart. You always put people you know, first. And yeah, but this time, remember, you're also important. This is time for you to reflect on yourself. This is for you, time for you to do your definition. This is what I'm getting. And now moving to the 10th house of the zodiac sign, which is ruled by Capricorn. Capricorn are born from December 22 and January 20. This is for you guys, my beloved Capricorn. I have the snake. It says, shed the old skin. And I also have the Winnie Gibbon 2. It says, fear. Okay, with this, I'm being told that with you, Capricorn, you know, it seems as if you are bearing grudges. You are always thinking about, you know, those bad things that happened to you in the past. Maybe when you were growing up or something. Now this is the time for you to let go. You know, forget about those things. All you need to do is to, you know, pray. Clear your mind and pray with a white candle. And make sure that all those bad things, you know, they're out of your life. You know, you don't think about them anymore. If you are surrounded by people, or if you are with one person who happens to bring, you know, those things that happened to you, I want you to be brave enough. Look this person in the eye and tell this person that, you know what, I've moved on. Don't remind me of those things that happened to me. I don't want to hear about them. You know, because the more you think about them, the more you put your energy on them, is the more that you are surrounding yourself with dark energy. You must stop thinking about this thing. You must move forward, okay? And you must know that your ancestors and your spiritual guides are always there by your side. They're protecting you always, and you must start attracting good things into your life. The more you put your energy on bad things, on the negative things that happen to you, is the more that you are inviting more negative things into your life. So you must stop doing that, okay? And you must also stop this thing of fear. Your ancestors used to be very brave people. So they were the type of people who will face a lion in the eye. They were the type of people who will face an obstruction, a distraction in the eye. You know, they will face problems, risk in the eyes, and they will come up with a solution on how to deal with this. So they will also want you to be like them, because you are the blood, you are the flesh. They expect you to be the same, okay? So stop being fearful. Face the problems in the eyes. Tell yourself that you are strong. Tell yourself that you are not alone. You are represented by your ancestors. You are with them all the time, you know. So stop in fear. Now coming to Aquarius, my beautiful Aquarius. You, my Aquarius, you fall on the 11th house of the zodiac sign. You are born between January 20 and February 18. Okay. I have the spring. It says see your seeds grow. And I also have the waning, Gibbous 6. It says wisdom. Okay. My beautiful Aquarius, you are the very ambitious one. You are the very intelligent. You are, you know, the spontaneous ones, because you always make sure that things happen and you want them to happen the way you want them to. When you're working on something, you will never let go until you achieve what you want to achieve. When you're working on something, you always make sure that you produce good results. You always make sure that whatever you're working on, you know, it's a good thing. It's a beautiful thing. People will like it. You always make sure that people like your work. And you are one person who lead by example. You are a good teacher. You are very much knowledgeable. You know what you want in life. And you always, you know, go after what you want, you know. And you always chase after the good things. This is what I like about you. So all they're saying is that they're happy about what you're doing. This is the message from your ancestor, from your spiritual guides. They're happy about what you're doing. They want you to continue doing that because this is a very good thing. And they're saying that you have the wisdom. You have the intelligent. This is what was given to you by the universe. You've been chosen. You are the chosen ones. You've been given this gift, you know, the wisdom gift. And all you need to do is to start using it. Use it in a good way. Of course, you are using it. They're happy about that. So they're saying that you mustn't lose hope. You must keep on focusing. For you, the sky is the limit. And with you, many people, you're going to turn other people's lives around. And for the good, this is what you're doing. Okay, now coming for our last zodiac sign, the one which falls on the 12th house. This is the completion of things. This is the Pisces, born on February 19 to March 20. My beloved Pisces, this is for you. I have the direction guardian. It says choose your path. I have the wolf moon. It says hunger. Okay. My beloved Pisces, with the direction guardian, all you need to do is to choose your path. Because you, my Pisces, you're one person, you know, sometimes you can't make up your mind. And when you make up your mind, you seem to be one person. Before you make up your mind, you know, you'll think about something, you know, thoroughly. You don't want to do a mistake in your life. If you're supposed to do something, you know, you want to, you will go, you know, you will go up and down, you know, searching your heart, searching your soul, searching your mind to find out if this is the good thing. Sometimes you seem to be tempted because there'll be so many opportunities right placed right in front of you. Or you'll find yourself trapped in a crossroad. You won't know which path to take. But I want you to know that your guardians are saying that you need to choose your path. They want you to choose the path. How are you going to choose it? You, my beloved Pisces, you are very, very intuitive. Very, very intuitive person. And as an intuitive person, believe in yourself. Believe in your intuition. Listen to it. It is going to guide you. It will tell you which path you need to choose. And it will also always choose for you the good path. Your intuition will never lie. It will never, you know, let you down. So this is what you need to do. Bring good things into your life. With hunger, I can say that you, my beautiful Pisces, you are hungry for, you know, for success. You are hungry because you have these creative ideas. You are a creative person. So you are hungry to see your creativity into action. You want to see your creativity turning into a reality. This is what you are hungry for success. And I wanted to know that with that, this will be a good motivation for you, an inspiration, and with it you're going to achieve your goals. You'll be able to reach the other side of the world, the spiritual world. You'll be able to go that side, to visit that side, you know, to connect to the guardians, to the spiritual angels, to your ancestors, and they'll be able to tell you what you need to do. And with this, if you choose the right path, you'll be able to, you know, to pray for other people, to pray on behalf of them, to pray for them, you know, to manifest good things into their lives, to make everything good for everyone. Because I like the fact that you are very much generous. You are never self-centered. You don't think about yourself only. You think about other people. I like what you're doing. This is very, very good. But beware of temptation, because you seem to be a little too soft. So this time, get rid of temptation. Listen to your inner voice. Your guides are going to guide you through your inner voice. Thank you so much, my beloved Pisces. Thank you, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, and Pisces. Let's meet again next month. Togo's.